leaving Rotterdam Central Station.
Okay. Hold on, let me put it on here. Yes. Okay. No. Almost outside of Rotterdam. Meanwhile, I'm taking out of my jacket. Let's see outside. There's nobody else in the first class. Building over there. I'm not sure if you could see it. But we are at Schiedam right now. It won't stop here. It will go right to Delft. Just hold on, guys. Wait, excuse me. Sunday today, so most people are either at church or they're working or they are doing nothing with their life. once you have those contacts in which you can place those, so 28% of consumers can charge the limit. Here at my left, and this is my left for you in the camera, for you on YouTube it may be on the right. But here's the west, the southwest of the province of South Holland. This is between Schiedam and Delft. And the city Delft is derived from the Greek word Delphi. They just made a Dutch version of it. It's also a city of Freemasons over there, so you know that. It's my day off, as you know, it's Sunday. I've been, how do I say, I've been thinking lately, and the Holy Spirit has been convicting me about some issues, some matters in me. And fear, guys. Fear. Basically, I'm talking about fear among human beings. Fear is nothing more than worshipping humans and demons. Just think about it for a moment. Fear, when you are afraid of someone, you are basically focusing on what they can do to you. That will be a disadvantage towards you. That's all. You're afraid of heights, then you have more trust in gravity than in the possibility that something might go wrong that you have in the most time. So every form of fear is basically worshipping something else than God. So every time you notice that someone is afraid, just locate what they worship. And fear also appears when the object of their worship is threatened. See, when someone is worshiping an idol, everything that will endanger the idol, they will perceive as a danger towards them. So they will become frightened when they are, you know, like when they are confronted with a reality that defies their idol. For some people, it's time management. We're going to Atoll now. For many people, it's time management. They are so afraid of losing time. Literally. So they don't have it to manage time. And every second that doesn't appear to be useful is a threat onto them. They are addicted at pursuing gain, pursuing money. Their greed has taken over their whole mental capacity. So they can't think straight anymore. And that's a sad thing. But it happens to many people that have grown up in Western Europe, the USA, and even in Japan and other countries that are considered industrialized. So, oh, by the way, this is Delft. This is a new railway station. It's below the ground. The former railway station is very old. It's from the 19th century, I believe, or beginning of the 20th century. I believe they've broken it down, but I haven't gone out in Delft yet to see it. If you watch some of my previous videos that I've made in Delft, you may be able to see the construction site when you were still building this area. It's still quite empty here in the first class, and I'm glad with it. Yes, okay. I can still charge my stuff. That's fine. I've talked about fear, and that fear basically implies that something else is worshipped. Besides, also implying that fear is also an indication of an idol is threatened. So, those that walk after the Spirit, those that are born again, let me say it like that, they shouldn't have any form of fear at all. Even if the fear of not being able to pay your bills, for example, that's a common fear among, you know, most people. You see, even that isn't right. Because, first of all, the Most High made clear that He is taking care of you. So if you become afraid of not being able to pay your bills, then you basically are placing trust in your own ability and not in God. And you see, this video is not a lecture, it's just me sharing some thoughts with you. But almost aside from the problem. next role for you and for any other being besides God is an illusion, is a fantasy. So, when you have humans wanting to gain control upon others, they're following a fantasy. Look, in the book of Revelation, Satan is called the serpent, the ancient serpent, the old serpent. By the way, Satan is the only spiritual being that's referred to as old. Something to think about. But let's move on. At the cross at Calvary, Christ is the egg. I just want to show this, guys. I'm not sure if you can see. Never mind. Look. Satan is referred to as the serpent, and he's defeated at Calvary. Okay, so he's a defeated serpent. A defeated snake. The snake is still deadly, that's true. But the snake is defeated. So how can a serpent that's defeated turn into this gigantic red dragon with 7 heads and 10 horns? And with crowns on his head. On his horns, I believe. How can a defeated serpent turn into that gigantic dragon? He can't. And he's defeated, right? So who is making him, Satan, is defeated into that invincible dragon? He's not invincible, he's defeated. The short answer is, we do it. We make him into that invincible dragon. We're the ones doing it. And yes, we have the audacity and the courage to blame the Most High for it. You see, in the book of Revelations, in Revelation chapter 13, it speaks of how the world will say of the first beast. The first beast is Apollo, one of the Nephilim children of Satan, but he basically gets all this power and authority and throne from his father, the devil himself. So Apollo is basically reflecting Satan himself. And the world is worshipping the dragon, Satan, and they are saying about the beast, which is the Antichrist. They are saying about him, who's like the beast, who can wage war against it. Or basically, it's like people saying today that the world order, you can't fight it. You know, the Illuminati, they are controlling everything. Or maybe they're not linking it to the Illuminati or anything. Or many people are saying it's like, well, people are just selfish, the world will never change. Or those thoughts that glorify the devil, that they give so much credit to him that he doesn't deserve. If humans are doing it. So basically, the whole world is terrified of an imaginary dragon. And they falsely believe that that imaginary dragon controls their lives. Well, that dragon is just a little dragon, just a serpent that's defeated. And because they believe that that dragon is that invincible and that great, they give power, authority, and a throne to the dragon, to Satan. So, basically, Satan gets his power from unbelievers and from ignorant Christians.